plunder and leave for dead. Rape for filthy lucre. Poison man and child. Sleep lightly. Retribution springs from the marshes with a belly full of flies. Everywhere. Small and lumpy. The Toad.
Eagle presents The Adventures of the Toad, the amphibious avenger who foils the plans of sharpsters, swindlers, and the professionally insane. Tonight, the atomic death. We'll begin tonight's episode in a moment. But first, Mr. John Barclay of the Eagle Wig and Hairpiece Company has an important announcement for all you listeners. Mr. Barclay?
Hello, friends. If you are bald or have thinning hair, you've probably come to depend on eagle wigs and toupees. Eagle wearers know an eagle will hold up in any kind of weather and will always look brand new. And now our crowning achievement, the Simon Eyes Freestyle Fiber King, the finest hairpiece money can buy. Made from the mane of the brown elk, the closest fiber to human hair, the Fiber King is sure to become a favorite. And it wears like iron. So for the safest, most durable, and up-to-date in hairpieces, insist on Eagle. From Hawaii to the Alps, the finest of scalps wear Eagle wigs and toupees.
Mercy Hospital, emergency ward.
Help! My children, they're not moving!
The epidemic?
Hurry, they're dying!
Bailiff, tell the jury they may recess until tomorrow morning.
Yes, Your Honor. Your Honor, the jury is dead!
Whether 'tis no blood in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows...
Never mind, Lewis, never mind.
What?
Now look at the audience.
Saints preserve us. They're dead!
That, Ricardo?
You can't expect us.
Don't tell me you can't find a cure. We're cut off now. No one will be let in or out of the city.
But
as acting mayor, I've got to get some answers or we can scratch Fairdale off the map.
We got every doctor and chemist working like demons to diagnose this plague.
That's not enough. But put every nurse, every ambulance driver, every candy striper on this thing.
Maybe.
Maybe what?
Maybe the Toad could help.
Yes, the boys at the Gazette would love that. New mayor, a belly flop. Toad called in. With the interim election on Tuesday, I'd sooner catch the plague.
I suppose you're right, though. Gee, say, you don't look too well, Your Honor.
What do you mean? I...
Oh, your teeth are dropping out. You're turning green. Oh, God of mercy! The new mayor! He's dead!
More black pudding, Miriam?
No, Clovis. Thanks anyway.
Nah, you've turned up your nose at everything tonight.
Yes, I'm afraid this epidemic has claimed my appetite.
Yes, a mysterious disease. Gruesome, unpredictable. Like something out of the Dark Ages.
Clovis, that poor man. It's like the end of the world. Shouldn't we try to help him?
I've been trying to for weeks now, Miriam.
You mean you've been looking for a cure?
Not exactly. Excuse me, miss, would you have anything in the way of a cordial or...
I'm sorry, sir. The restaurant is closed.
Oh, my.
Ladies and gentlemen, please leave the restaurant.
Clovis, it's like something out of a nightmare.
Go straight to your homes!
Come on, Miriam. I'll tell you about my theory in the car. So I leapt into action.
But why? Surely it's a case for the medical teams, for scientists.
Miriam, believe me, it's a case for the Toad.
But Clovis...
The symptoms of this epidemic are not entirely foreign to me. I read about them once in a journal of experimental physics, too obscure to be known to our fine local doctors.
I'm afraid I missed it too, Clovis.
They are the symptoms.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.